Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is narrator Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about blowdown of a gauge class. Why do we need a blowdown and how we are going to do a blowdown? And what do you mean by normal blowdown? What do you mean by cross blowdown? All things will be explained in today's video. But before beginning the video, I want to tell you that I have made a video regarding safety in gauge glass introduction. If you want to know about the gauge glass, you can click on the I button and I will also keep the link in the description. So let's start the video of the blowdown of gauge glass. The first questions come to our mind is that what do you mean by blowdown? So blowdown means that to ensure that the cocks, these are the cocks, steam cock, water cock, drain cock. These cocks are clear and these passages are clear, and to ensure that the level showing in the gauge glass is correctly representing the water level which is been maintained inside the steam drum, to ensure that we are doing the blowdown. Means blowdown means having high pressurized flow of the water or the steam to ensure that there is no blockage. Okay, so in this diagram right now, which you see is a normal tubular type gauge glass. Okay, and basically it consists of three cock: steam cock, water cock and drain cock. And in this diagram what right now you can see, this is a tubular type gauge glass which is not directly attached to the boiler casing. It is attached to the boiler casing via a hollow gauge attachment. Okay, so now as you can see, first let's see this thing. Okay, the normal tubular glass which is attached to the boiler casing. So in order to carry out the blowdown, what procedure we should follow? First let's see this procedure which I'm going to tell you. This, if you tell in an exam of MEA class 4 or class 2, they will pass you, because this is the correct procedure which is in mentioned in Reed's volume 8 and G.H. Flanagan. So first thing what you will do, you will close the steam cock and water cock and open the drain cock. So the steam cock and the water cock should be closed, and after that we'll open the drain cock. Okay, now if there is no leakage in the gauge glass, nothing should be blown out. Okay, so if there is no leakage in the cock, in the steam cock and water cock, then there should be no any blowdown sign should be there, because as the steam cock and water cock is closed and drain cock is only open, so there should be no blowout. After that, open and close the water cock to check the water cock line is clear. So first step is what? It's close this cock, steam cock, water cock and open the drain cock. After that, when the steam cock was closed now and drain cock was open, now open the water cock. The water from here will come and will gush out and blow out from drain cock. Okay, indicating that the water cock line is clear. After that, close it. Open and close the steam cock to check that the steam line is clear. Okay, now after ensuring that the water cock line is clear, we close it. Now we open the steam cock, and when the steam cock is open, the steam from here will come and will gush out from here, indicating that the steam line is clear, and again close it. Okay, so what we have done till now, we have first closed the steam cock and water cock, and we have opened the drain cock which indicate the drain cock line is clear. After that, we have opened the water cock, open and close the water cock to indicate the water line is clear, and after that we have open and close the steam cock to indicate water steam cock is clear. In all this process, the drain cock was open. Okay, now after ensuring that the steam cock and water cock line is clear, what we will do, we will close the drain cock. We will close the drain cock, and after that we will open the water cock. And as the water cock will be open, the water will come from here and will fill the hole of the gauge glass. Okay, after that, when we will open the steam cock, then the steam from here will come and it will push down the water to the level such that which will be maintaining inside the steam drum. Okay, the same thing I've written here. Open the water cork B. Water will gradually rise up to the top of the gauge glass. Open the steam cork. As the steam cork will be open, water in the gauge glass should fall to the level of the water inside the boiler. Okay, very clear. Now, this is the normal procedure of the blowdown, which is done in a gauge glass. If anyone asks you, tell what is the blowdown of gauge glass, you should tell this procedure only. But if someone asks you, tell me the procedure of cross blowdown, then you will tell, you have to tell this procedure which I am going to tell you. So now the second procedure which I am going to tell you is called cross blowdown. As you can see in this diagram, that the boil gauge glass is not directly attached to the boiler casing. The gauge glass is attached to the hollow column, and that hollow column is attached to the boiler casing through an isolating valve. So in order to make sure that the whole cork line is clear and this isolating valve is also clear, we will follow the procedure of cross blowdown. So first thing what we will do, we will close the steam cork, close the water cork, open the drain cork. Okay, after that what we will do, now as the steam cork, water cork is closed and drain cork is open, we will also close the steam isolating valve and close the water isolating valve also. So we will close all the four valves, we will open the drain cork. After that what we will do, we will open the water isolating valve and open the steam cork. You think you should check that. We will open the water isolating valve E and we will open the steam cork A. Okay, water will come from here, will fill up the whole hollow column and will come out from the steam cork and will be drained through a drain cork. Okay, now this procedure ensure that the water isolating valve is clear and the steam cork line is clear and the thing line is clear. Now after opening E and A, we'll close the steam cork A and we'll close the water isolating valve E. After that we will open the steam isolating valve D and we'll open the water cork B. Now the steam from here will come, will fill up the hollow column and will go through the water cork and will drain to the drain cork, indicating that the steam isolating valve and the water cork line is clear. Again we will close the whole thing. After that again all the four valve is closed and drain cork is open. Now we will close the drain cork, we will open the water isolating valve, steam isolating valve, and then we will open the water cork and then the steam cork, and whole thing will be bring back to normal level. So as you have seen, to ensure that the cork and the valve are clear, we are following a procedure of cross blowdown. Why it is called cross blowdown? Because to ensure that the steam cork is clear and the water isolating valve is clear, we are opening E and A. And to ensure that the water cork and steam isolating valve is clear, we are opening D and B. Therefore, the cross method is followed, hence it is called cross blowdown principle. So in this video I have told you what is the normal blowdown procedure and what is the cross blowdown procedure. And if you have liked the video, please do hit the like button and please do subscribe. And if you think you have learned something, please do share with your friend also. Marine Engineering Hum aim is to bring all our marine personnel to this platform so that we can learn and grow together. Please help me to commit to my aim. Please share the video. Image credit goes to GH Flanagan and reads volume 8. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.